Maya and we are students from Ramon Turró High School.
And we are here today to present you our project.
We are going to talk about Sidney Shostak, that was a brigadist that came here to fight against Franco.
At the beginning of the 20th century, Francisco Franco used the force to carry out a coup d'etat. He started at the Canary Islands and then conquered the rest of Spain. Of course, a lot of people tried to resist and fight against fascism. Spain was divided into two, the people from the right side and the people from the left side. They were both at odds, and if they had to kill someone, they didn't have pity. At first, Hitler agreed not to help Spain, but he finally decided to do it. He gave up a lot of weapons and some tanks to kill the rebels. Mussolini also helped. He gave some submarines to sink ships like Ciudad de Barcelona and to spy the Republicans. A lot of volunteers from all over the world came to Spain to help. They came because if in Spain had triumphed the fascists, all over the world would be fascist, earlier or later. These volunteers are called brigadists, and they saved a lot of people.
On 30th May 1937, a ship, Ciudad de Barcelona, that was going from Marsella to Barcelona, was sunk by an Italian submarine. The ship contained 2,050 European volunteers and 50 Americans that came to fight against the Franco's repression. When the ship sank really fast in Malgrat de Mar, many people died, 50 to 60 persons more or less. When the ship was sinking, people that were inside were singing an international song. Luckily, it was sunk close to the coastline, and some people were saved by fishermen. People of Malgrat de Mar were very hospitable, and the survivors were very thankful.
Belchite Battle is a Spanish Civil War battle that took place in Belchite, Zaragoza. This battle happened from the 24th August until the 6th September of 1937. Belchite conquest moved a big number of Republican military. 80,000 men took part in this battle. Some of them were part of the East Army, and the major part of them were part of the International Brigade. The most part of the international brigadists were British, Canadian, and American.
Our project talks about Sidney Shostak, an American brigade member. He was born in Newark in 1911. He was single and he didn't have any children because he died very young. He studied CSE at a high school in Washington, and when he finished studying, he started working as a painter and paper hanger, but he also worked as his father's assistant. A few years later, he became famous in Washington because during a period of time, he was president of the local Union Teamsters. Moreover, he was also delegate of the Central Task Union. After the Ciudad de Barcelona accident, he joined the Lincoln Battalion and he was Commander Robert Merriman's assistant. He died on 6 September 1937 at Belchite Battle.
Hi, my name is Nerea.
And my name is Claudia, and we want to expose you our opinion.
We were surprised by the amount of foreign soldiers who risk their lives and abandon their country and their families to fight against fascism and stop its extension. We believe that today there would not be as many volunteer soldiers as then, because we live in a conformist and selfish society that has adopted an individualistic attitude. It has also been surprising that in a town with a monotonous and apparently normal life has lived a historical success so important.
Recuérdalo tú y recuérdalo a otros, cuando asqueados de la bajeza humana, cuando iracundos de la dureza humana, este hombre solo, este acto solo, esta fe sola. Recuérdalo tú y recuérdalo a otros.
En 1961 y en Ciudad Extraña, más de un cuarto de siglo después, trivial la circunstancia,
forzado tú a pública lectura. Por ella con aquel hombre conversaste, un antiguo soldado, en la Brigada Lincoln.
25 años hace, este hombre, sin conocer tu tierra, para él lejana y extraña toda, escogió ir a ella y en ella, si la ocasión llegaba, decidió apostar su vida, juzgando que la causa allá puesta al tablero entonces, digna era de luchar por la fe que su vida llenaba.
Que aquella causa parezca perdida, nada importa, que tantos otros, pretendiendo fe en ella, solo atendieran a ellos mismos, importa menos, lo que importa y nos basta es la fe de uno.
Por eso, otra vez hoy, la causa te parece como en aquellos días, noble y tan digna de luchar por ella. Y su fe, la fe aquella, él la ha mantenido a través de los años, la derrota, cuando todo parece traicionarla. Mas esa fe, te dices, es lo que solo importa.
Gracias, compañero. Gracias por el ejemplo. Gracias porque me dices que el hombre es noble. Nada importa que tan pocos lo sean. Uno tan solo basta como testigo irrefutable de toda la nobleza humana.